Blessed be his kingdom, now and forever. Amen.
Almighty God, to you all hearts are open, all desires known, and from you no secrets are hidden. Cleanse the thoughts of our hearts by the inspiration of your Holy Spirit, that we may perfectly love you and worthily magnify your holy name, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Recite what I have fashioned for the king. My tongue shall be the pen of a skilled writer.
You are the fairest of men. Grace flows from your lips, because God has blessed you forever. Your throne, O God, is yours forever and ever. A scepter of righteousness is a scepter of your kingdom.
You love righteousness and hate iniquity. Therefore, God, your God has
has anointed you with the oil of gladness above your fellows. All your garments are fragrant with myrrh, aloes, and cassia. And the music of strings from ivory palaces makes you glad.
King's daughters stand among the ladies of the Lord.
On your right hand is the queen, adorned with the gold of Ophir.
Thanks be to God. and also with you.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ according to Mark.
Glory to you, Lord Christ.
Now when the Pharisees and some of the scribes who had come from Jerusalem gathered around Jesus, they noticed that some of his disciples were eating with defiled hands, that is, without washing them. For the Pharisees and all the Jews do not eat unless they thoroughly wash their hands, thus observing the tradition of the elders. And they do not eat anything from the market unless they wash it. And there are also many other traditions that they observe, the washing of cups, pots, and bronze kettles. So the Pharisees and the scribes asked him, "Why do your disciples not live according to the tradition of the elders, but eat with defiled hands?" And he said to them, "Isaiah prophesied rightly about you hypocrites, as it is written, 'This people honors me with their lips, but their hearts are far from me. In vain do they worship me, teaching human precepts as doctrines.' You abandon the commandment of God and hold to human tradition." Then he called the crowd again and said to them, "Listen to me, all of you, and understand. There is nothing outside a person that by going in can defile, but the things that come out are what defile. For it is from within, from the human heart, that evil intentions come: fornication, theft, murder, adultery, avarice, wickedness, deceit, licentiousness, envy, slander, pride, folly. All these things, evil things, come from within, and they defile a person." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Christ.
Roman Catholic teaching, women are not ordained. through our various church doctrines that we stray from God. I recognize that many denominations turn to Scripture to form their set of teachings surrounding various topics. But the question then becomes, where there are opposing views, such as the ordination of women, which scriptural view becomes the true one to be of true religion? Sorry, the mask keeps going up into my eyes. Which leads into the next hot topic outside of scripture that might land me in some hot water here. Let's talk a little bit about our religiosity surrounding masks and mask mandates in our current pandemic. I have heard people lament that having to be vaccinated or to wear a mask in a store, restaurant, or even a church is a violation against their rights to live freely. I have also heard people lament that they cannot live freely to go out and enjoy life because people will not wear a mask in public or become vaccinated to speed up herd immunity or to create a safe space. And even in these instances, our faith, our religion, can guide us into two thoughts here, that I'm a God-fearing person and God will protect me, or Jesus calls us to love our neighbor, even if it means sacrificing our convenience for a season. So the question here becomes, whose rights and liberties are truly being violated when both have a school of thought, a doctrine surrounding it? Which is the true religion on how to live in a pandemic? And does our religion, our faith, guide any of that? Our New Testament reading from the letter of James, we hear talk about being religious and how and what it means as a follower of Jesus. And indeed, in the Gospels, we hear about Jesus teaching about religion and speaking out, as we heard in this morning's Gospel, to those who hold on to these religious actions, which I will get to in a moment. For James, his letter is Jewish in nature, suggesting the church was still predominantly Jewish. Jews knew what it meant to be religious. Do you remember the criticism the Pharisees and scribes gave to Jesus' disciples? They did not wash their hands according to the religious teaching. For the Pharisees and all the Jews do not eat unless they thoroughly wash their hands, thus observing the tradition of the elders, and do not eat anything from the market unless they wash it. And there are also many other traditions that they observe, the washing of cups, pots, and bronze kettles. And yet for James, and Jesus for that matter, being religious had more to do with what comes forth from one's heart and from one's mouth. As a whole, James's epistle reflects the heart of Jesus, the character of Jesus. James indeed says we are birthed by the word of truth, that is, being born into God's truth and word, which is embodied in Christ. And as Christians, we have a religious action that reminds us of that, of being birthed, which is baptism. Jesus implores us to be doers of the word, not merely hearers who deceive themselves. And Jesus compels us to respond and be obedient to the word of God. And James invites us to ponder and to dig a little deeper. For he says, for if any are hearers of the word and not doers, they are like those who look at themselves in a mirror. For they look at themselves and go on away, immediately forget what they were like. But those who look into the perfect law church, partaking in the sacrament, going to Bible studies, personal devotions. Let us reflect on our character and how it guides our words and our actions. Is our character aligned with Jesus? Does our character align with Jesus as we heard at the end of James, looking out for the widows, for the orphans, for those who are other in our communities, for those who are sick, who are in prison, who need our help? And if we answer honestly, I'm sure we can say that some days are better than others. I know that for myself, some days are better than others. Yet there is hope, because there is always, always room to live deeper into the life of Christ. Amen.
Amen.
Unseen.
We believe in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only Son of God, eternally begotten of the Father, God from God, light from light, true God from true God, begotten, not made, of one being with the Father. Through him all things were made. For us and for our salvation, he came down from heaven. By the power of the Holy Spirit, he became incarnate from the Virgin Mary and was made man. For our sake, he was crucified under Pontius Pilate. He suffered death and was buried.
On the third day, he rose again with glory to the Scriptures.
He ascended into heaven and is seated at the right hand of the Father.
He will
come again in glory to judge the living and the dead, and his kingdom will have no end. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Lord, the giver of life, who proceeds from the Father and the Son. With the Father and the Son, he is worshipped and glorified. He has spoken through the prophets.
We believe in one holy Catholic Church.
We acknowledge one baptism for the forgiveness of sins. We look for the resurrection of the dead and the life of the world to come. Amen.
Prayers for people who aren't killed. I ask your prayers for God's people.
we have sinned against you, thought, word, and deed, by what we have done, and by what we have left undone. We have not loved you with our whole heart. We have not loved our neighbors as ourselves. We are truly sorry, and we humbly repent. For the sake of your Son, Jesus Christ, have mercy on us and forgive us, that we may delight in your will and walk in your ways to the glory of your name. Amen.
And also with you. What's the prize?
With the prize.
I was just going to say, I was going to go there. We're talking about a raffle before, every raffle. There have been two quilts that came down with me from Canada that are queen-size quilts that my mother has made to help us in our fundraising efforts for our organ restoration. And book doesn't have to order more because people want to get them. So this is an exciting time for us. It was a big fundraising project, and it was a little different with the windows because you could do it in chunks, whereas the organ, we can pay our backs, pay back to ourselves slowly, but it seems a little bit more, what's the word I'm looking for? Strenuous?
Arduous?
What's that?
Arduous?
Arduous, that all of a sudden we see this amount kind of thing, and it's all in one chunk, but we'll get it done. And as good stewards, we have borrowed from ourselves, and we will pay ourselves back as good stewards. So for those joining us online, if you're into quilts, or if you know someone who has quilts and would like to purchase a couple raffle tickets, please contact us. And those are all the announcements I have. I'm a long-winded, I know. Any other announcements? Walk in love. Oh, our...
I'm just going to add, with the flea market, there are a few spaces left, but there are no more tables left for people. And what else? There's something else I wanted to say. Oh, and on the 10th, which I believe is the Friday before, we're going to, some people, are going to help organize the donations that have come in and kind of get everything set up on the tables.
All right.
On the 10th, right?
Mm-hmm.
And
right.
So anyone who would like to help on the 10th, I would say what, around 7 o'clock or so? 6, 7, whatever. There'll be somebody here around then. So you can help.
We'll finalize the time, and that way next week we can give it full force and put it in our newsletter. Walk in love as Christ loved us, offering himself a sacrifice to God.
Thank you.
praise you, we bless you, we give thanks to you, and we pray to you, Lord our God.
Lord, we pray that in your goodness and mercy, your Holy Spirit may descend upon us and upon these gifts, sanctifying them and showing them to be a holy gift for your holy people, the bread of life and the cup of salvation, the body and blood of your Son, Jesus Christ. Grant to all who share this bread and cup may become one body and one spirit, the living sacrifice of Christ to the praise of your name. Remember, Lord, your one holy Catholic and Apostolic Church, redeemed by the blood of your Christ. Reveal its unity, guard its faith, preserve it in peace, and grant us to make mine our inheritance with the Blessed Virgin Mary, with patriarchs, prophets, apostles, and martyrs, with Saint John and all the saints who have found favor with you in ages past. We praise you in union with them and give you glory through your Son, Jesus Christ, our Lord. Through Christ, and with Christ, and in Christ, all honor and glory are yours, Almighty God and Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, forever and ever.
Amen.
And now, our Savior Christ has taught us, we are bold to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, and the power, and the glory, forever and ever.
Therefore, let us keep the feast. Alleluia.
The gifts of God for you, the people of God.
Thank you.
the body of your Son, and heirs of your eternal kingdom. And now, Father, send us out to do the work you have given us to do,
to love and serve you as faithful witnesses of Christ our Lord.
To the Holy Spirit,
the honor and glory, now and forever. Amen.